a truly great artist to the world, but to those who live in his birthplace, the edgy melting pot of Brixton in London, he will always be theirs. Our Europe correspondent Emma Keeling went to talk to them.
He was a global music icon, but to people here in Brixton, David Bowie was their boy.
We know that he was born here, so he's one of our own local boys, so it's sad, really sad day.
Just across the road from the tube station, fans and media from around the world gathered in front of this mural. They brought flowers and shed tears for a man who influenced music, fashion and culture.
He's a master of reinvention, and that means that he's a kind of transcended generations and could appeal to everyone.
Just days earlier, on Bowie's 69th birthday, he released his 25th studio album. Fans were hoping for another tour from the man who rewrote the rules and pulled different aspects of art into his music. So when the UK woke to the news, it was a complete shock.
I just sort of sat down with Sam to my hand, and I just dropped it like, and I just looked at John, and I said, what? And he went, yeah, David Bowie's died of cancer.
If you're a fan of David Bowie, you'll know about this place, Heddon Street. It's a tiny little street, David Bowie singing out over the loudspeakers, and it was here that he was photographed for his album, The Rise and Fall of Ziggy Stardust and the Spiders from Mars. So many fans have come here to share their memories. It's a sad day for them. It was 1972. Ziggy propelled him to global stardom. Now a plaque commemorates the man who changed everything for so many.
I started to dress like him, you know what I mean? And people used to say to me, what are you dressing up like Bowie for? Like, so I said, well, he's the best.
But his influence has never waned, and even in death, the brilliance of Bowie will live on. Emma Keeling, One News, London.